says Maria Flores, a native of Uvalde, was last seen near the town of Newt. Her vehicle was recently discovered abandoned, with officials reporting no signs of foul play. Authorities are hopeful that the expanded search into the nearby communities of Morro and Chinatown will unearth new leads. Family and friends are urging anyone with information regarding her disappearance to please come forward. New details have emerged in the grisly string of murders that littered Interstate 40 during 1971 and 72. Known only as the Terror of I-40, authorities say an unidentified woman spent years hitchhiking from Texas to California, where she viciously murdered several truck drivers and three other young women along the route. Billy Jasper of Winslow, Arizona, claims he likely had an encounter with the assailant at his home over a year ago. Jasper says a young woman in her 20s approached his home. After a few minutes, the woman allegedly became irate with Mr. Jasper's line of questioning. Eventually, the unidentified female started to attack Jasper with a razor blade. He was able to defend himself until the attacker eventually fled.
You can do this. Think.
See what you made me go and do?
Thank you.
us here.
search continues in Muerto County for a missing University of Texas student. The sheriff's department says Maria Flores, a native of Uvalde, was last seen near the town of Newt. Her vehicle was recently discovered abandoned, with officials reporting no signs of foul play. Authorities are hopeful that the expanded search in the nearby communities of Harlow and Chinatown will unearth new leads. Family and friends are urging anyone with information regarding her disappearance to please come forward. The remains of an unidentified male have been discovered near Devil's River off Highway 163 in southwest Texas. A Cedar Canyon resident stumbled upon the scene while hunting early yesterday morning. Authorities have confirmed this is approximately the same location where two females were discovered last June. All of the victims appear to have been stabbed and strangled to death. Although the cases have similarities, investigators have nothing more to share at this time. The search continues in Muerto County for a missing University of Texas. The sheriff's department says Maria Flores, a native of Uvalde, was last seen near the town of Newt. Her vehicle was recently discovered abandoned, with officials reporting no signs of foul play. Authorities are hoping.
something I can use? Doors. I can use that.
Did those kids find us? Should be more careful.
Thank you.
Search continues in Huerto County for a missing University of Texas student. The Sheriff's Department says Maria Flores, a native of Uvalde, was last seen near the town of Newt. Her vehicle was recently discovered abandoned, with officials reporting no signs of foul play. Authorities are hopeful that the expanded search into the nearby communities of Harlow and Chinatown will unearth new leads. Family and friends are urging anyone with information regarding her disappearance to please come forward. The remains of an unidentified male have been discovered near Devil's River off Highway 163 in southwest Texas. A Cedar Canyon resident stumbled upon the scene while hunting early yesterday morning. Authorities have confirmed this is approximately the same location where two females were discovered last June. All of the victims appear to have been stabbed and strangled. Although the cases have similarities, investigators have nothing more to share at this time. The search continues in Huerto County.
Did they really leave? I don't know about this. Yeah. looks like some kind of lockpick. Oh, thank God. Around here somewhere. Be careful, Anna.
Another disturbance was reported at the abandoned slaughterhouse outside of Hills Prairie. Deputies responded to a caller reporting loud noises from the dilapidated facility after midnight. Police investigated the site and found evidence of trespassing and minor equipment theft, but suspect it is merely the work of local vandals. The search continues in Muerto County for a missing University of Texas student. The sheriff's department says Maria Flores, a native of Uvalde, was last seen near the town of Newt. Her vehicle was recently discovered abandoned, with officials reporting no signs of foul play. Authorities are hopeful that the expanded search into the nearby communities of Harlow and Chinatown will unearth new leads. Family and friends are...
See what that is. This looks like some kind of lockpick. Thank God. This might stop the bleeding. Still around here somewhere. Be careful, Anna.
Oh!
Please, protect us. Please.
Get moving! Find him!
search continues in Muerto County for a missing University of Texas student. The sheriff's department says Maria Flores, a native of Uvalde, was last seen near the town of Newt. Her vehicle was recently discovered abandoned, with officials reporting no signs of foul play. Authorities are hopeful that the expanded search into the nearby communities of Harlow and Chinatown will unearth new leads. Family and friends are urging anyone with information regarding her disappearance to please come forward. New details have emerged in the grisly string of murders that littered Interstate 40 during 1971 and 72. Known only as the Terror of I-40, authorities say an unidentified woman.
Something I can use around here.
Thank you.
Muerto County for a missing University of Texas student. The sheriff's department says Maria Flores, a native of Uvalde, was last seen near the town of Newt. Her vehicle was recently discovered abandoned, with officials reporting no signs of foul play. Authorities are hopeful that the expanded search into the nearby communities of Harlow and Chinatown will unearth new leads. Family and friends are urging anyone with information regarding her disappearance to please come forward. New details have emerged in the grisly string of murders that littered Interstate 40 during 1971 and 72. Known only as the Terror of I-40, authorities say an unidentified woman spent years hitchhiking from Texas to California, where she viciously murdered several truck drivers. Authorities were alerted to Hellum's ranch yesterday to investigate reports of cattle abuse, but what they found instead was disturbingly serene. The ranch was devoid of livestock. Instead, 13 men, all dressed in plain white clothes, were sitting in chairs spread throughout the property. Each one was wearing a simple rope belt, a pair of sunglasses, and holding a copy of King James Bible. No man showed signs of abuse, neglect, or trauma. The sheriff's department believes each man ingested some amount of potassium cyanide, judging from the large quantity that was discovered in the kitchen. No reason has been given as to why these men may have taken their lives, but this reporter just learned of the existence of a manifesto discovered in the pocket of one of the men.
Where the mountains reach like fingers to the sky, never ask why, love never dies.